So during lockdown, I've been at the channel time and again, trying to explain to people the story of what's going on. In 2018, 300 people came across the channel in inflatable dinghies. Last year, the number was nearly 2,000. This year, it's over 3,000 already. Bearing in mind, more people come in the August, September months when the weather's warmer, the sea's warmer. We're on course this year for something like 7,500 people to come across the channel. I've exposed the fact that despite giving £61 million to the French, that the French Navy actually escort the boats over the channel. I've proved that. It's not disputed. Since I've tried to get the public to understand the problems with this, the fact that over 80% of those that come are young males, generally between sort of 18 and 26 years old. Nearly all of them have no identity papers. They claim to come from Iran, but clearly many now come from Eritrea and goodness knows where else. And a lot of you have been in touch with me to say that all over the country, they've seen some strange things happening. They've seen local hotels being filled up with asylum seekers, illegal immigrants, call it what you will. And one of the first places that got in touch with me was some residents here in Bromsgrove in the West Midlands. So I've come up today to have a look. We're gonna go to the Bromsgrove Hilton to find out if it's true that 147 people who've come into the country, been put from Dover onto coaches, which are there almost every day, gonna find out whether it's true that that hotel is now full. Now, I think it probably is, because you try and book a room in the Bromsgrove Hilton, have a go. The number doesn't answer. The booking form says that basically it's full for the rest of the year, and this during the middle of the crisis. So let's find out what's going on here in Bromsgrove, but I promise you, whatever we see here today is but the tip of the iceberg. So the staff there all got sacked?
No, not all the staff, but I do know, I think she was a chambermaid up there.
Yeah.
Somebody's daughter who worked on reception.
Yeah.
She got sacked.
Yeah.
They was furloughed and then they was like, lost their jobs.
There must be someone working there. Strange, isn't it?
She said that, yeah.
Odd. Well, I'll get to the bottom of it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I will.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Thank you, nice to see you.
At least you do something about it.
I'm trying. I'm trying. Well, there we are. It's what we're getting. What we're getting is people saying the biggest problem is that young women are a bit scared to go out because there are gangs of 8 or 10. And the big wolf whistle, and they're feeling uncomfortable. That's the main thing. We've heard other stories too, but that's the main thing at the moment that we seem to be getting. I understand the local MP, Sajid Javid, has said nothing, but he said to you that it would be temporary, did he?
I had an email from him saying that it was a temporary arrangement, yes.
Yes, yes. Well, it doesn't look very temporary.
No, it doesn't.
Because we tried to book a room, and you can try for this week or next week or September, and there are no rooms available.
Hello, Mr.
Hello there, Mark. How are you?
Yeah, what are you doing, Tatsa?
Well, I've come to visit your butchers, of course. No, I did these videos about the English Channel, about all the migrant boats coming over, illegal migrant boats coming over. Since I've been here, I've been told Sajid Javid said it would be temporary, but it's not. It looks to be permanent.
Really?
I don't know. Well, that's the impression I'm getting.
And we were told I was told it was temporary. I was told the government had taken it over. They were going to move them on. Apparently there's 600 around the country as well.
Hello.
Hello, Nigel.
Bit of a shock, I'm sorry.
A real shock, a nice one.
Good, thank you. There's no media reporting of this whatsoever. Mm-hmm. And here you are, a little village in Worcestershire. And you've got 147 young blokes, you know. Now, people have told me that Sajid Javid said it was going to be a temporary thing, but it's not, is it?
No, it's not. Never is, is it?
No, never is. And we tried online to book rooms.
I tried as well when I was trying to check it out.
Oh, did you? We're in Cats Hill. We're finding out how local residents feel about what's happened to the local hotel. We're 147 young men, mostly between the ages of 18 and 26, had been parked. What we've learnt already from residents is that Sajid Javid promised it'd be temporary, but when we tried to book a room, there are no rooms to book. You'd have thought hotels were empty. This one is full. Thank you for letting me into your home and both of you for talking to me. Did it come as a big shock when you found out what had happened?
Yes. Apparently, we all knew about it and we were supportive, according to our local newspaper. We didn't even know.
No, I was told that there was a consultation.
No, there wasn't.
No.
According to the Advertiser and the Standard, we were all very supportive.
Oh.
How come we didn't even know? And that's the truth of it, did we, Andy?
Just moved him in. I'm black.
And what I've discovered is it's not just you suffering from this. We're now housing 48,000 people like this.
It's just unbelievable.
At a cost, an estimated cost over the next 10 years of £4 billion.
Yep.
You are getting free accommodation, free healthcare, free dental care. You are getting £40 a week spending money.
Don't.
I mean, and you can see why people come.
You can see why people come, yeah.
The question is, why don't we do something about it? So in short, how do you feel about the fact that your local hotel is now going to be a permanent
center? I'm really annoyed. Really, really annoyed.
Have you told Sajid Javid how you feel?
No, because whenever I email him, he doesn't bother to come back. It's just a waste of time, to be honest. If he came to my door, I'd tell him. Again. I'm really annoyed at Boris. Pretty per town, she talks a talk, but she doesn't know what she does.
Well, she keeps talking about the Dover stuff, you know, but nothing so far has happened. And the consequence of open doors is what you're seeing down the road here.
Mm.
Staff cars. So here we are at the Bromsgrove Hilton. Here's the car park. Completely empty. And yet we couldn't book a room when we tried. We did try. They're booked for months and months, it would seem. I wonder why. So windows are open, so people are staying here. This is the Hilton Bromsgrove. Let's have a quick look. Yes. Just come and have a look. Can we book rooms here?
I'm afraid not.
When?
You can't book my boyfriend, sorry.
Right.
Over the ground.
Can we have a look around?
Not really, because it's closed.
It's closed. Yeah. We've got lots of people
there. Hotel is closed to the public.
Who's it open to then?
I can't disclose your information.
Okay. Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, and you?
Okay, thanks.
Goody good. You staying here?
Yeah. Could you not for a week, please?
Okay. So this is a completely closed off site now, is it?
Yeah.
You work for Serco, do you?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, nice work if you can get it.
Thanks a lot.
Well, that's the end of our visit to Bromsgrove. As you saw, I walked into the hotel there. Was not welcome. It's closed, but of course it's not closed because all 147 beds are taken. Challenged by the bloke, asked to get out, told not to film. I asked him, do you work for Serco? He said yes. That company, has been awarded a £2 billion contract over the next 10 years. Now, given that the numbers coming in across Dover are actually bigger than projected, it'll be more than £4 billion. And I want to make this point, all right? It's costing us £4 billion. There are 48,000 people in this situation already. Even if their claims for refugee status are refused, which they mostly are, they will still stay in the country. They'll leave the hotel, they'll finish up working, you know, picking fruit, working in the rag trade in Leicester, or whatever it is. They will move into the illegal slave economy in this country. This government, Conservative government, and we're here, by the way, in a Conservative constituency. Sajid Javid, former Home Secretary, is the MP. This government is doing nothing about it. There was a big sign on the White Cliffs of Dover saying, everybody welcome. It's costing us a fortune. And a further thought, we've no idea who some of these people are. We've no idea whether some of these might be ISIS. It's possible, I don't know, but we have seen failed asylum seekers committing horrible acts in our country before. We should not be doing this. I want this story to be out there and be talked about. Oh yes, I know. Of course, mainstream media will condemn me for even daring to talk about it, but it is the truth. We should have a proper debate about it. And please, if in your local area, one of your hotels has been filled up in similar circumstances, please contact us at the end of this video, because I want the full story of what is going on in our country.